Hello students, this is your biology teacher Ranjana Kanojia, and today we are going to study part 2 of chapter 6, Fundamental Unit of Life. In our previous lecture, we have discussed what is cell, discovery of cell and cell theory. So today we will start with a quick revision of cell theory. Cell theory states three major points. Number one, the cell is the smallest unit of structure of all living beings. Number two, the cell is the unit of function of all living beings. Third, omnicellular e-cellular, or all living cells, arises from pre-existing cell. So now we are going to discuss what does cell theory means. And for discussing this, we will take two examples: a plant such as mango and an animal such as man. So first we will discuss cell is known as structural unit. If we take any part of the body of man or any part of the mango tree and examine it under a microscope, then it will show a cellular structure. So it is confirmed that all the living organisms are composed of cell. Next is, why cell is known as functional unit of living being? So any function in the body of man or in the mango tree is due to the activity in its cells. For example, movement of man is due to the contraction of muscle cells. Food is digested by the enzymes which are secreted by gut cells. Digested food is absorbed by the cells, and absorbed food is used up by cells for various metabolic activities. Now in mango tree, photosynthesis occurs in the cells of leaves. The root cells absorb water from the soil and so on. So here you can see that all the functions inside the body of any organism are performed by cell. That's why cell is known as functional unit of life. Next we will discuss, cells die and are replaced. So the body of the man or a mango tree is composed of millions and millions of cells. Many of these cells continuously die and are replaced by new ones, which are formed by the process of cellular division. So formation of cells from pre-existing cells is a never-ending chain, and by this process new cells are formed from the pre-existing cell. Next we will discuss, most life starts as a single cell. So the life of the man and the life of a mango tree started as a fertilized egg and as a seed respectively. The egg was a single cell produced by the cells of the ovary of mother, and the mango seed had an embryo that is formed after pollination and fertilization, which also started as a single cell in the ovary of flower of the parent mango tree. So it was understood that most life starts as a single cell. Now we are going to study organism on the basis of number of cells. As we all know that the bigger an organism, greater is the number of cells in its body. So on the basis of number of cells, organisms are categorized under three categories. They are single-celled organism, few-celled organism and multi-celled organism. So first we will discuss about single-celled organism. Single-celled organism are also known as unicellular organism. So a unicellular organism is an organism that consists of single cell. This means all the life processes such as reproduction, feeding, digestion, excretion, circulation and so on, all of these activities occur within a single cell. For example, amoeba, bacteria, planktons and yeast are present in this category. They are typically microscopic and cannot be seen with the help of eyes. Now we will discuss about few celled organism. So some very small plants and animals are made up of relatively few number of cells, just a few hundred and few thousand cells, and these are known as few celled organism. For example, Spirogyra and Volvox. Now we will discuss about multicelled organism. These are also known as multicellular organism, as they are made up of many cells. So in these organism, tissue grade or organ grade of body organization is present. In these organism, a specialized cell perform a specific function. For example, in human body, trillions of cells are present. Now we are going to study about the size of cells. Cells are very small and they cannot be seen with naked eyes, so we can only see a cell under a microscope. Smallest cell is PPLO, or pleuropneumonia like organism, which is a bacteria. It ranges from 0.3 to 5 micrometer. If we talk about cells in human body, then RBC is the smallest cell in human body and its diameter is 7 micrometer. Longest cell are nerve cells. Largest cells are birds, eggs, actually ostrich egg. Now we are going to study cells and their efficiency. So smaller the cell, greater its efficiency. It could be understood as cells generally remain small in size, and this is because of two main reasons. Number one, different regions of a cell can communicate with each other rapidly and for the cell to function efficiently. Number two, cells have a large surface area by volume ratio for greater diffusion of substances in and out of the cell. The second one is quite interesting. So to understand the second advantage about surface area by volume ratio, imagine a cube with each of its sides measuring 2 mm. Now the total surface area of this cube will be 2 mm multiplied by 2 mm multiplied by 6 surfaces, which will be equal to 24 square mm. Now suppose if we cut this cube into 8 equal smaller cubes by reducing each sides to half its previous length, then the total surface area of these 8 smaller cubes will be 1 mm multiplied by 1 mm multiplied by 6 surfaces multiplied by 8 pieces, which will be equal to 48 square mm, which is double that of the original large cube. So in smaller cubes, the diffusion efficiency increases as its surface area is increased. The large surface area relative to volume of a cell ensures greater diffusion of nutrients into the cell, metabolic waste from the anterior to the outside of the cell, respiratory gases like oxygen into the cell and carbon dioxide out of the cell. Any damage to the cell can be easily repaired if the cell is small. Now we are going to study about cell shapes. So cells vary greatly in their shape, and these may be dish-shaped, polygonal, rectangular, cuboidal, thread-like, branched, or even irregular. These shapes of cells are often related to the different functions that they perform. For example, human red blood cells are circular and biconcave. In order to pass through the narrow blood capillaries and to transport oxygen. White blood cells are amoeboid or amoeba-like movement, and they also bear pseudopodia so that they can squeeze out through capillary walls. Nerve cells are long to conduct impulse from distant part of the body to the brain and vice versa. Muscle cells are long and contractile in order to pull or squeeze the parts. Guard cells of stomatal pore in the leaves are bean-shaped
to open and close the pore. Now we are going to study about the structure of prokaryotic cell. So here is a diagram of bacterial cell. Bacteria are classified as prokaryotes that have simplest form of body organization. They are single-celled organism. Bacterial cell do not contain nucleus, so their genetic material floats inside the cytoplasm. So in the diagram you can see that with the help of red color, the genetic material of bacterial cell is represented, which is floating inside the cytoplasm. Bacterial cell may also contain circular DNA, which is known as extrachromosomal DNA or plasmid. Bacterial cell contains 70S type of ribosomes that perform the process of protein synthesis. As bacteria is a prokaryote, so they do not contain any type of membrane-bound cell organelles. Generally, bacterial cell remains surrounded by two covering. The outermost covering is known as cell wall, and inside it, the second covering is known as cell membrane. Some bacteria do not contain cell wall at all, like mycoplasma, while some contain an extra wall that is outermost covering and is termed as capsule. So here in the diagram you can see that the outermost covering is capsule, after that cell wall, and inside cell wall there is cell membrane. Bacterial cell bears a large hair-like structure. It is termed as flagella. It helps in the process of locomotion. The capsule of bacteria or bacterial cell remains surrounded by many small hair-like structures, which are termed as fimbriae or pili. These structures help the bacterial cell to attach with the host cell. That's all about bacterial cell, which is a prokaryotic cell. Now we are going to study about the structure of eukaryotic cell. So eukaryotic cell have a well-defined nucleus along with other membrane-bound organelles. So here in the diagram, you can see that at the center, nucleus is present, which is surrounded by other membrane-bound organelles like mitochondria, represented with red color, ribosomes, represented with black color in the diagram, lysosomes, represented with mustard color, then Golgi bodies, represented with blue color, endoplasmic reticulum, represented with brown color in the diagram. All these cell organelles are held in their position by cytoplasm, which is protected by plasma membrane. So here in the diagram you can see there is a plasma membrane which is represented with pink color. Plant cell is surrounded by an extra covering known as cell wall. So here in the diagram there is no cell wall is present, so it is a diagram of animal cell. We will study all of these cell organelles in detail later. Now we are going to discuss difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. So most prokaryotes are unicellular. That means that prokaryotic organisms are made up of single cell. Most eukaryotes are multicellular. That means that eukaryotic organisms are made up of many cells. Next, the nucleus is poorly defined due to the absence of nuclear membrane in prokaryotes. That means that in prokaryote, no nuclear membrane is present, because of which their genetic material remains suspended inside the cytoplasm or floats inside the cytoplasm freely. While in eukaryotes, the nucleus is well defined and surrounded by nuclear membrane. That means that in eukaryotes, nucleus is present and it is surrounded by an envelope termed as nuclear envelope that protects the genetic material of eukaryotic cell. Third is, nucleolus is absent in prokaryotes while nucleolus is present in eukaryotes. Cell organelles such as plastids, mitochondria, Golgi bodies, etc. are absent in prokaryotes, while cell organelles such as plastids, mitochondria, Golgi bodies, etc. are present in eukaryotes. In prokaryotes, 70S type of ribosomes are present, while in eukaryotes, 80S type of ribosomes are present. Bacteria and blue-green algae are prokaryotic cell. Fungi, plant and animal cell are eukaryotic cell.
Now we are